Hey guys, my name is Vikas and in this quick Photoshop tutorial, let's create this type of nice and simple text design inside of Photoshop in a few simple steps. So let's jump into the Photoshop and get started. Alright, so here we are in Photoshop and first of all, we have to take a new page. So click on this create new. And here we have to set the size of the page. So let's select in pixel and set the width value 1920, height value 1080, resolution 72 pixel per inches. Select this color mode RGB color, click on create and just go to your layer panel and here click on this lock button and unlock this layer. Go to FX and click on this gradient overlay. And here we have to select a nice gradient color. So click on this gradient and this is the first point and this is the second point. So you can select any color from here. So I'm gonna use this purple for the first one, this blue color for the second one, hit OK. You can adjust this point as well and hit OK. After that, let's close this layer. Let's type a text over here. So for the text, click on this text tool and go to character. If you can't see this character, then go to window and check this option character. And here you have to select your favorite font style. So in this case, I'm using this Go Bold font style, which is very suitable for this project. So I'm going to use this Go Bold and you can set the size of this text, maybe 400 pixel and now you can click over here and type anything that you want. After that, we have to align this text in the center. So what we have to do, just select this move tool, select this text and the background layer and just go over here. And here we have this alignment tool. So click on this align horizontally, click on this align vertically. Basically, we have to set the text in the center of this frame. All right. And after that, right click on that and go to on this option group from layer, or you can also simply hit Control Z to create a group. All right. And hit OK. Now what we have to do, just select this ellipse tool and go to in this corner, hold left mouse button, hold alt and shift on the keyboard and let's create a nice big circle just like this. And what we have to do, we have to create one more copy of this. So hit Control J on the keyboard to duplicate or simply right click on that layer. Or you can also click on this option, duplicate layer, as you can see. All right. And after that, double click on that and let's call it ellipse 2. Select this move tool and let's set this circle over here maybe. And after that, we have to duplicate this group layer. So select this, right click on that, click on duplicate group. Call it group 02 and let's create one more. Right click on this group 2, click on duplicate group and this is gonna be group 3. Hit OK. Basically we have to create three copies of this group. All right, after that we have to attach a mask with this group 2. So select this group layer, click on this layer mask and do the same thing for third one. So just select this third group, click on this layer mask and now select this group 02. Here we have to fill black color on it. So select this pure black color, hit alt and backspace to fill black color. It means foreground color into this and do the same thing for third one. So select this one, hit alt plus backspace to fill black color into this. And after that, what we have to do, just select this one, go to the first ellipse, hold control and click on this icon and we get this round selection. After that, just select pure white color and I'm gonna fill white color in the selection. So hold Alt and Backspace to fill white color on that area, and do the same thing for this one. So select this group 3 mask, and for this one we have to click on this ellipse 2 and make a selection on this ellipse, and after that hold Alt and Backspace to fill the white color on this mask. All right, and after that hit Control D to deselect, and let's delete the first ellipse and second ellipse as well, and after that we get the normal thing. All right, and now what we have to do, just select this second group, go to FX, add a drop shadow effect on it, and now we get this type of effect as you can see. So you can increase the opacity of this, so I'm going to use 40% maybe, and it's looking nice. You can see the setting of this drop shadow as well. So I have set the distance 0, spread 10, size 100, and opacity 40%, and apply same drop shadow setting on this one, group 3. So select this group 3, go to FX, click on this drop shadow, and apply same drop shadow setting for this one, hit OK. And as you can see, we get this type of text design in few simple steps, and it's looking awesome as you can see. Alright, so that's all for this video guys. I hope you like it. If you like it, then hit the subscribe button, click on the bell icon, and also hit the like button for this video. And my name is Vikas, and I will see you in the next one. Till then, bye bye.